think what's interesting about land art is that it uses the elements from nature to convey a message. So, as opposed to traditional art where you use paintings and sculpture, whereas that's a second-hand medium, with land art, what you're using is the elements themselves. So there's that power or the essence that you're working with. You're working with processes, not set mediums. When you're doing this type of work, the one thing you do start to see is the gradients in nature. Like these leaves, very soft gradient, whereas this whole creek bed is made up of stones, which is very hard. And it's the proximity to the elements that you're trying to reflect in the art. Like, eventually, if we left this piece long enough, it would turn brown and decay away, but that's part of the process. Eventually this work will fade away, something will come, maybe wind will blow it away. So in a sense, it's not really the now. This is one step of this process. It's not the final product. This is just a moment in time. So at one end you've got the thickest part of the tree, which is the trunk, and then as you go up and out into the branches, it thins out and gets thinner and thinner. And you can see the same element in leaves. At the base of the leaf and running through the leaf is the thickest part, and then as the veins branch out, they get thinner and thinner, so you get this same element reflected in two different parts of nature. And you can show progression of an element very well in a circular shape. It really is the case that things flow in a circular motion, that life becomes death, which goes back into the earth, and then it grows again. So it's never actually gone, it just changes shape, changes texture, the energy dissipates back into the system. I think a lot of modern life is opposed to nature. We see it as a background, not the actual foreground of life. We go into nature and don't see ourselves as part of nature. And I think that's what's lost. As older cultures and older civilizations have been forced to work in the natural world, so they never lose that connection, whereas modern day life revolves around unnatural processes. You've got water, which is a glassy material, you've got rocks, which is a hard material, and the sunlight, which is illuminating this piece in different ways. And as the sun goes down here, it'll bring on a whole new dimension to this work. And when I first started on this piece, when I pulled the rocks out of the water, they were still wet, so now that they're drying off, it'll really highlight the shape of this piece. This flow takes a long time. It's not a very fast movement. Nature can be violent, but in a lot of ways, it takes a very long time for things to change. And the progression of water through this environment really highlights that and really shows that sense of movement and progression and evolution of things. It's such a powerful thing to have nature work through this piece, that you can see the evolution of time as the water progresses down this work and into the river.